Hey everybody, welcome to dance class for the Sensitive Mover. My name is Sam Stone and I will be your teacher and guide for today's class. This is the second series of the classes, and for this series we'll be experimenting with tone. So that is an extra little play that we'll be putting on top of the sensing into the body. The other thing to know is that for this series, I've been asked to demonstrate a few more of the ideas in my own body. So I do encourage you to look at the screen if that is helpful for you. But if you are the type of learner who just wants to listen to this and use it as an investigation playground, I encourage that also. Today's class is called Carry Me Basket. Now, the basket that I'm speaking of is the rib basket. And the rib basket is another word for rib cage, if you were wondering. I prefer rib basket because we're going to be looking at the very round shape of our ribs, as well as the mass of that ribs and the potential for movement that our ribs have. I am also really curious about how the ribs can flex and forgive. And then also, like I said, how they have the potential for force. So to begin looking at the ribs, I want to take out some anatomy images. So please come onto your screen and we'll just be here for about 5 minutes. Okay. Right here we have ourselves a rib basket. I want to use the image of this anatomy to help inform our dancing. I wouldn't get too stuck up on the specifics if it's over your head. But it's important to notice that our rib basket is very, very round and composed of different arcing ribs. There are 12 of them that move from the front all the way around, round, round into the back. They insert themselves into the thoracic spine, which also has 12 vertebrae. So that is one rib per vertebra. And this entire shape, as you can see, it holds its own. It's really separate from the other pieces of the body. And we're going to use that idea to explore what in axisyllabus is called a motoric mass. A motoric mass is a mass that has a motoric value to progress the body in space. So we're going to do the same thing, imagining this mass as a potential force. And not only the mass of the ribs, but also everything that it's attached to, including the shoulder girdle, the sternum, and the shoulder blades surrounding also we'll consider the vertebrae themselves. Including all of that, we have all the stuff that's inside of it. So you really have to imagine that this carries all of your organs, all of your muscles, and that also equals masses to move in space. Okay, I want to look at how these ribs really attach to the vertebra, because that is what's going to indicate how the ribs are able to move in space. At the very bottom of the rib cage, we are going to be at the bottom of the thoracic spine. The lowest rib inserts itself into T12, and we're going to look all the way up 11, 10, 9 to 8 to indicate an area of the thoracic spine that has a lot of motion potential and therefore can act as a bit of a swerving mobile base to carry the entire rib basket on it. In fact, in the axisyllabus, we would call T8 through 12 the anatomical center, or it can be called a triaxial motion center. Triaxial motion center is any joint that's found in the body that has the potential to be quite mobile, because it's able to move not only back and forth in one direction on one pathway, not only in two different pathways, but it can move in three different pathways. And actually, if you imagine I'm carrying my ribs, can move between and arcing. And so really, really quick, because we will be looking at it during our improvisation, let's find our hands on our sternum and really just crawl our fingers around our ribs, remembering they're there attaching into the sternum. The sternum is more or less the front side of where T8 would be. So imagine that T8 and under it, 9, 10, 11, 12, to find where we're gonna have that really mobile spot, that triaxial motion center that can move around the vertical, take a little buoyant bounce around it, making sure that you're moving from that point and not the neck. And can move around the sagittal, basket floating in water, vertical, sagittal, and horizontal, which kind of expands and contracts the ribs. I'm excited to get moving, so let's lay down on the floor. We'll warm up through guided improvisation and eventually get to move through these different motions. Lying on the floor with your legs and arms facing down, flat to the ground, we're going to begin this class by simply checking into your own body. You can close your eyes if you wish. Noticing which parts of your body are touching the floor. Checking in if some body parts are a little bit heavier and some other body parts don't quite carry the same weight. Maybe some body parts feel like they touch the ground much more on one side and not as much on the other. And we're just checking, seeing, noticing, not judging. Perhaps if there's a body part that feels like a little tense or a little bit harder, you can simply ask it to let go, soften, forgive. Often a body part might be reluctant to let go, and you can either go and visit another body part and forget it for a second, or you can wait for it, give it patience as it finds some sort of release. Might be a bumpy jostle to release. It might just release like a pop of air. Starting to come into focus your breath. And let your breath be whatever it is. Are you able to see if your breath moves your ribs? Like a balloon open side to side, or perhaps forward and back, filling up the back space as much as the front. Can your breath fill all the way into the upper regions of your shoulders, letting it fill in slowly like a crystallization. And then when releasing, letting go, no action required. As you start to notice how your ribs participate in this breath sensation. Checking to see if your face has been relaxed during this investigation. That also counts as a body part, letting the jaw go. Letting the idea of the ribs go back into what is it that you notice in your body. Maybe you have a need, maybe you want to shift. And continuing to follow my voice, you can move your eyes slowly to the camera if you would like to see the demonstration. Otherwise, continue to listen to my voice. Finding yourself laying on the floor, bringing your knees up. Letting the music come in as aid to the dance of your breath. Finding your hands and placing them onto your rib cage. Fingertips falling slightly to the sternum. Thank you. exhale, really help your ribs and your hands forgive into one another. When you're ready, find those hands back on the sternum and bottom of the rib cage. And start to move your rib cage up and down, head to toe. Feeling its small shift in space before adding maybe another direction. Perhaps a rocking. Also moving those hands around just like before with a little bit more pressure and play. Imagining the full roundness and mass that is within our rib basket. Start to move that rib basket so that you're receiving more mobility and rock through space. As you roll from side to side, playing with breath and rock and the fullness of those ribs. I might move towards where the breath is. I might deflate away from it. I might imagine the breath at the lower rib. Retrieving. ribs move in space. Might be a very simple investigation of just tracking where are your ribs in different positions. With the ribs coming into a standing position, we're going to continue the exploration of where are your ribs in space. This time, inviting in the idea that we can move around that triaxial motion center. Combinations of. The ribs decide where we go. Starting to let the arms just be a second thought to where the ribs are. As if your basket is floating through the water and a few threads hang off of it, trailing behind. Perhaps your basket tips sometimes, or maybe it stays more on the surface. Continuing your dance. You have 2 more minutes of exploration. Baskets. floating with the potential to move around those three different axes. Buoyant through the space with arms tracing behind. Last minute, continue to notice where is your rib basket in space. And if you want to add some breath, you can add that to the dance. Yourself a resolution to this dance as we come back together towards the camera. Okay, now that we have moved around in a softer way, we're going to change pages into the tone exploration of the class, adding a little bit tone. So in order to get toned up, we're going to do some toning exercises, some strength exercises. You will be happy if you have yourself some sort of soft towel, and if you have maybe some kind of chair or stool. Also helpful is a wall. Okay, pause it if you need to get those things. Other than that, let's get started for our quick toning up, getting stronger. Here we go. Okay. To get started, we'll get ourselves a nice thing for the ground. So we're gonna do some push-ups and knee. I keep my knees down at this point for my push-ups. Otherwise, you can do your own. For these push-ups and for the entire toning exercise, I really wanna concentrate on the ribs. So we're gonna take the concept through and use it in order to dance a workout out instead of feeling like we have to count or get through it. We're gonna dance our way through. Starting with our hands, we're gonna reach for the floor, a little slight turn out position. As you see, when you turn them out a little bit, palms down, you start engaging the back a little bit more. So keep to the outside of the hands, and we'll do ourselves some push-ups. Filling the rib cage up, keep it round. As you lower it up and down. And do as many, plus a little bit more that feels good. If you feel done, get yourself into a child pose and get stretched. We'll catch up in 1 second. Keep those push-ups or your child pose if you want to stretch it out. Remember, keep those shoulder blades into the back by turning out the arms. Nice stretch. All right, meet us in a plank. Arms are in, once again, turning out of the upper top of the arm into the back, fluffing out the ribs, and let's hold it here. Noticing the ribs the entire time. Do they have the forgiveness that we played with before? Can they tell your butt to take some of that forgiveness? And keep it going, and if you need a break, take it into a little stretch up front of the belly. Not slacking, but
pushing away from the floor just a little bit. Once again, shoulders and arms turned out so that they're into the back. All right, we'll take the plank to the side. Here we go. Never thought I'd be a workout Barbie. Taking out these ribs, really making sure that they're round all the way into the back. And also forgiving. Neck is soft. All right, other side. Keep this structure in your view, not behind you. And puff up, 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 up. Round, round, round. Holding it here. Toning up. Woo. Okay, we're going to start ourselves with a crawl. A very fun thing to do with our ribs all puffed out and engaged. We're going to crawl through space and simply think about your ribs being the driving force of this crawl. So as I go forward, ribs are really arcing round, round, round to reach out that arm. Ooh, you can't see. Here we go. They reach out, 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 around to place the arm, letting the head displace over the support arm. And backwards. Carrying those ribs through space. This time, let's listen to the support a little bit more, dropping the head so that we can really arc over that arm. Okay. Woo! Nice stuff.
Moving on.
Okay, as you put your things away, we'll get started for the next section, which is the experiment with adding a little bit of tone to this rib basket investigation. I am particularly curious now about how the rib baskets are carried in arcs throughout space when shifting from foot to foot, and the arms trail behind as a little bit of an echo of that arc in space. In order to do this, really quick, we just need to know about the arm safety. The joints of the arm can be quite flexible for some. But in this case, if you want to take your arm, you can feel a little relationship, torso pulling the arm through. And if I don't have that relationship, my arm doesn't get to ride the arcs of the basket. The basket in this case and the arm following is an example of what we call an axisyllabus as the lead and lag phenomenon. I think the name says it in itself. So this investigation is moving between your feet and arcing the basket around them and letting one arm at a time follow. I'll tell you when to switch. Let's see. Now that was me, totally loosey-goose. This time I'm gonna make some choices that you can add into yours with tone. So that means I might carry the arm with the torso and the cage, or basket as we call it, or I might hold it in space and make choices about that arm dancing as I wish. Knowing that I always have the potential to move the basket, and then have the arm echo what I'm doing. Okay, I'll talk you through it. Picking one arm and letting it ride behind that rib basket. Does your elbow bend at times, or does it stay straight in space? Remember, the ribs in space have a very arced nature about them. How do your ribs arc in space, and your arm trails that arc as evidence? Changing levels and directions. And changing onto the other arm. Tone, you might add a little choice making and design of the arm in space staying. Tone of the arm attached to the rib basket in space. Or different shades of letting it go. Remember, we call it a motoric mass. Let it drive that arm in space. Let it take you through the space. We have tone now in our arms and in our legs to help us propel through space with a little bit more force. If you haven't already, perhaps both arms come out in space for our last minute. Swinging arms in space as the rib basket carries them. Resolving that dance smaller and smaller. Here comes our last investigation. It is basically a choose your own adventure. You can do everything and anything we worked on today, which is quite a lot, with the focus on the rib basket through space. I myself am gonna play around as the music is on, and it's really great to just realize your imagination. You have the opportunity right now, alone in your space, to do so. So here is to that. See you in 5 minutes.
Thank you.
coming on over to the camera, far ending goodbyes, walking away from the camera and towards the camera, and walking through the space. Lunging back one leg, turning it in and out of the front, in the back, dropping into the side, pumping those ribs up and over that arm for a nice loose stretch. Twisting right at that point, up, knee, abdominal center. Switching to the other side, leg turned in and out, other leg turned out, up, arcing over. Writing supplies. I'll put on a timer for 5 minutes. Thanks for coming to class. Hope you got nice and sweaty like me. Bye.